I welcome you all to the virtual commencement exercises of the Duquesne University School of Law, class of 2020. Thank you for joining us for this very special day in the lives of our graduates, their families, and this institution. I am pleased to announce that 132 graduates will today receive the degree of Juris Doctor. To begin our ceremony, I ask Father Bill Christie, University Chaplain and Director of Spirit and Campus Ministry at Duquesne University, to offer the invocation.
Let us pray. Holy Spirit of God, Spirit who hovered over creation, Spirit who inspired prophets and preachers and psalmists, Spirit who overshadowed Mary at Nazareth, Spirit who emboldened the apostles, Spirit who gives life, and to whom this university is dedicated. Draw near to us this day, for we invoke your holy name. Our graduates gathered when they matriculated into Duquesne University of the Holy Spirit. On that day, we prayed to you, Holy Spirit. We asked your protection and providence over them. As they studied, matured, discovered, created, this you have done, and this we give our abundant thanks and praise. Now, once more, on this day, Spirit of God, be with us and bless us. Bless our graduates. Bless their family and friends. Bless their professors. Bless the entire university family and all who have assembled to witness this great occasion. Let us know your presence now in this ceremony, just as we have experienced your loving care in the years that are being culminated by the granting of these degrees. Holy Spirit, hover over us now, for we make this day an oblation to you. We pray this in your most holy name. Amen.
Before I begin my remarks, I have the honor of announcing two teaching awards. First are the adjunct awards. Criteria used in selecting the recipients include enthusiasm for teaching and learning, interest in the students, sensitivity to the learning environment, and innovation of instruction. This year's recipients are Judge Jeffrey A. Manning for the fall semester and Judge Thomas M. Hardiman for the spring semester. The second award is the Excellence in Teaching Award, which recognizes a full-time professor who has made outstanding contributions in teaching. The recipient must also demonstrate the ability to engage students actively in the learning process through teaching that is intellectually rigorous and innovative. I am pleased to announce that this year's recipient is Professor Ashley M. London. Congratulations. Now, class of 2020, what a wild ride it's been, but here we are. We made it. I'm going to keep this short and sweet so we can all get back to whatever streaming service is currently consuming our lives. This afternoon, from the comfort of my dining room, I would like to say a few things about perseverance and responsibility. To get to this point, we have all shown tremendous perseverance. Some of us have come from college and others have worked before deciding on law school. But we all have had the same desire, the desire to strive for greatness. That journey has not come smoothly, with a lot of long nights, some strong coffee, and a lot of Zoom classes towards the end. We found new friends, we found new hangouts, we've gone from happy hours at Buford's to trivia night at Milano's and spent basically every other hour at Super Bowl. But perseverance is something that we all have and something that we're not going to lose. It's a desire to do more and be better that will make us take the leap to a new firm, explore a new industry, or maybe even start fresh in a new city. Now that we are graduating, we are becoming members of a society of professionals and are in a position of tremendous power. That power has corrupted some of those that have come before, and it may corrupt some of those that will come after, but I have no worries about my fellow graduates. I believe that we are ready to uphold the ethics of the legal profession and make Duquesne proud with our conduct, both personally and professionally. Duquesne has taught us to be leaders, independent thinkers, problem solvers, and most importantly, legal research and writers. Strong emphasis on legal research and writers. but I'm confident that we will use the power imposed upon us for positive change. We will move forward from Duquesne and strive to follow the teachings of Gandhi, and we will be the change that we want to see in the world. And as we strive for that mission, we should not forget the words of Pittsburgh legend Dan Marino. I've been a Dolphin for 17 years, and I'll be a Dolphin for the rest of my life. It's really inspiring. But all joking aside, I'm proud to be a member of Duquesne Law Class of 2020, and I'm excited to be the first to call you all doctors. Doctors of jurisprudence, but doctors nonetheless. Next stop, Esquire. Thank you.
Good morning. I am April Barton, and it is my honor as Dean of Duquesne University School of Law to address the class of 2020. On behalf of the faculty, I salute you. I also salute the families and loved ones of our graduates, because without your support, the class of 2020 would not be here today. A very special thank you to President Gormley and Provost Dowsey and the entire university administration for your never-ending support of our law school. I offer my sincere thanks to our law school staff and administration who tirelessly serve our law school with professionalism, aplomb, and grace. And thank you to our tremendous faculty who have challenged, mentored, taught, and inspired each of you, our graduates. Today is a day of great celebration amidst a backdrop of challenge and uncertainty. And throughout this most difficult time, you have persevered. You have completed every course, overcome every hurdle, and passed the finish line. Accomplishing this great goal, now more than ever, took immense courage. Hold tight to that strength you have developed, for it is this courage, this fortitude, that will guide you as lawyers. In practicing law, you can never underestimate the role of courage. To do the right thing, to fight for worthy causes, and to seek justice everywhere. From the founding of the United States forward, lawyers have helped us through every crisis, from the drafting of the Constitution to the enactment of civil rights statutes. And you now join their ranks during one of the most challenging periods of history. But as you leave the law school and become lawyers, know this: wherever you go and whatever you accomplish, you have the entire Duquesne Law School family standing behind you and with you. You are not alone, and we are eternally proud of you. You have overcome obstacles, challenges, setbacks, and were able to complete your studies during a world pandemic. And in doing so, you have displayed strength, character, resilience, and gratitude. I am tremendously proud of each and every one of you. Take time to be proud of your own great accomplishment of earning a Juris Doctor. And take time to acknowledge the support of your family and loved ones on this momentous day. You are our hope. You are why each of us as faculty do what we do every day. You are the future of our profession. And with you, our future is in the very best of hands. You are no longer students of the law, but rather its ambassadors and protectors. I ask for God's blessing on each of you in the most exceptional way as you seek to serve our society, the pursuit of justice and the rule of law, with the many gifts God has granted you. Next, it is my honor to present the law school's top three student awards to our most deserving graduates. The first award is the John J. Schullo Peer Excellency Award, named in honor of the late John J. Schullo, who served from 1982 until 1993 as the eighth dean of the law school. This award is given to the graduating student who, in the judgment of the graduating class, is worthy of the admiration and respect of his or her fellow students. This year's recipient is Tricia Ann Martino. The next award is the Dr. John and Liz Murray Award for Excellence in Student Scholarship, which is named in honor of the university's 11th president, Dr. John Murray, and his wife, Liz. Dr. Murray served as a distinguished member of our law school faculty for decades and was a leading scholar in the field of contracts. This award is presented to the graduating student who authored the most outstanding published law review article of anyone in the graduating class as selected by the advisors to the Duquesne Law Review. I am pleased to announce that this year's recipient of the Dr. John and Liz Murray Award for Excellence in Student Scholarship is Gerard Hornby. The final award on behalf of the entire law school faculty is the Distinguished Student Award. This award is presented to the graduating students in the day and evening programs who, in the judgment of the faculty, have displayed general scholastic excellence and who have performed meritorious service to the law school. I am delighted to announce that this year's recipients are Danielle Marie Mirjanovic and Joanne Lynn Paris. Congratulations, Tricia, Gerard, Danielle, and Joanne. And now it is my distinct pleasure to announce the law school's commencement speaker, Judge Elliot Housie. Many of you know Judge Housie as an Allegheny County Court of Common Pleas judge or as the Allegheny County Public Defender. But we at Duquesne know him as a member of our Duquesne Law family. Someone who is always there for our students and who embodies the mission of our university and our School of Law, because Judge Housie has dedicated his life to helping others. While you can read Judge Housie's impressive biography in our commencement brochure, truly the impact of his career on our society goes far beyond his notable positions. This is because since the mid-1990s, he has tirelessly dedicated himself to mentoring first-year students. Regardless of how busy he is, he makes time every week to meet with our students. This servant leadership is what truly makes us proud to call him an alumnus, and why I was compelled to invite him to share in this special day as our commencement speaker. Your Honor.
Thank you, Dean Barton. I want to congratulate the class of 2020 on your noteworthy accomplishment. Your years of hard work, dedication, and commitment have finally paid off, and you have achieved your goal of becoming attorneys. Additionally, I would like to acknowledge your family members and close friends for the love and support that they've given to you over the years. Although many of you are convinced that you're solely responsible for this most recent achievement, I want to assure you that without their support and assistance, you undoubtedly would not be graduating from law school. So please take the time to thank them for their countless sacrifices. During these unprecedented times in the midst of a pandemic, you've had to remain focused and unshaken in order to complete law school. Your ability to remain steadfast in your commitment to becoming attorneys speaks to your work ethic, your character, and your tenacity. Unfortunately, graduation is not the end of the challenges you will face. The world has been shaken to the core by the coronavirus, and the fallout will impact all of us. For some of you, this may result in a job market that has become much more constricted with fewer opportunities. Do not be disheartened. This too shall pass. You'll find a path to where you wish to go. It just may take a more circuitous route than you wished or imagined. Sometimes what matters in life is not the destination, but the journey. To those of you lacking confidence and looking at your classmates who have landed the coveted high-paying jobs and feeling as if you failed, please take solace in knowing that I too share those feelings upon graduating. But I want to inform you that it's not how fast you're out of the gate, it's how you run the race, and life is a marathon. You have the tools and the intellect to finish the race in good form, and the skills and traits that you possess will enable you to become capable, competent, and successful attorneys. As you prepare to begin your career, some of you will have the privilege of practicing law prior to taking the Pennsylvania bar exam. Others will have the start of your careers delayed briefly. You clearly have demonstrated a history of making sound decisions. You enrolled at Duquesne Law School instead of Pitt. Nevertheless, as new attorneys, I implore you to be mindful of how difficult it is to develop an exemplary reputation, and yet how easily it can be destroyed with one poor decision. Additionally, I encourage you to respect your clients and your colleagues. Although the practice of law is adversarial, it should not be antagonistic. And as attorneys, we have an obligation to lead by example. While you have a duty to represent your clients and their interests passionately, remember to be kind to the people that you encounter, because those interactions will form the basis of your reputation. I want to remind you of the importance of working hard and continuing to challenge yourself, because the practice of law will require you to do so on a daily basis. The act of graduating from law school does not signal the end of your education. It is merely the beginning. You must continue to possess a desire to learn in order to become a successful attorney. I want to challenge you to take the risk of stepping out of your comfort zone as practicing attorneys, because this is the process by which you will grow and develop as attorneys. Lastly, always take the time to celebrate the victories and successes, but pay more attention to your failures and losses, because you'll learn far more from those experiences. Again, I say congratulations to the graduating class of 2020 for a job well done. I wish you much continued success. God bless you and your families.
Commencement ceremonies are important occasions to come together, to reflect on our mission and goals, to remember happy and good times, and to celebrate accomplishments and excellence. For this reason, we take great pride in announcing the School of Law's graduating students who have distinguished themselves through academic achievement. It is to these students that we dedicate this day. Associate Dean Ella Quisnick will announce the names of the graduating students.
John Paul Abda. Catherine H. Akins. Callum T. Appleby. Destin Michael Bohorich. Madison E. Barrick, cum laude. Tyler C. Bartholomew. Elizabeth Ann Becker. McCall M. Beringer. Joseph Birkebau. Cassandra Lee Boyer, summa cum laude. Nicholas Andrew Brady. Kyle T. Braun. Eric John Bruner. Kelly S. Buchanan. James B. Campisi. Angela Rose Capoletti, summa cum laude. Kelly Wilson Capone. Maria V. Carr, cum laude. Dana L. Corey. Elena Diane Corey. Katie Marie Krystalowski. John Alphonse Dollar, cum laude. Jamie Lynn Davis. Jacob A. Dean. Danielle M. DeLiva. Krista Marie DiPaolo. Annette Livia DeHannix. Ryan J. Dunn. Elizabeth Rose Eckerd. William T. Fagan. John Frederick Fink. Catherine M. Flynn, cum laude. Brianne M. Frawley. Brianna Nicole Gallagher, Ellie Elaine Gandolfi, Harry Reed Garrison, magna cum laude, Marco G. Garza, Azure Goodwin Rowe, Baada Arena Gray, Julianne Graziano, Michael Adam Green, Danielle E. Grimm, Kelsey Jean Gross, Jacob Charles Hanley, Samantha Jade Hansen Len, cum laude, Gerard Hornby, summa cum laude, Megan Lynn Hornay, cum laude, J.C. Lynn Hunter, Neil R. Eisler, Kaylin C. Jakes, cum laude, Ashley R. Javier, Bridget Aaron Kearney, Benjamin Michael Kelly, Patrick Kelly, cum laude, Kristen L. Kitzman, Allison Marie Kashut, Mary Elizabeth Kuznick, Jennifer Ann Lipinski, Zachary Lebo, Benjamin M. Lehman, Amanda May Leonard, Joseph Richard Lewis III, Sarah Eileen Linder, Alexander Locke, Kristen Carl Lungen, Ryan Lutz, Paul A. Lavara, Michael James Majorello, Nicole J. Maloney, Mariah Nicole Mandy, magna cum laude, Corey Samuel Marasco, T.J. Marletta, David A. Martin, Tricia Ann Martino, magna cum laude, Derek L. Maltzby Jr., Zachary M. Mazzarella, Teresa McCruden, Caitlin Elizabeth McCurdy, Emily Wong McKenzie, Michael Angelo Melodini, Luke Vincent Menzel, Alexander Miller, Melanie Marie Morgret, Danielle Marie Mirjanovic, magna cum laude, Jacob T. Naylor, Samuel C. Nolan, magna cum laude. Oluwaseyi Ayamiku Odunaya, magna cum laude. Caitlin Oliver. Joanne Lynn Paris, summa cum laude. Juan Carlos Paz Rosario. Alex Wolf Pillow. Alexandra Piper. Charles Mitchell Pacino. Andrew Kevin Pratt. Kelly Colleen Prilla. Stephen John Reddy, cum laude. Mallory Joe Reed. Kyle Rodewald. Charlie Rossini. Emily Rose Sanchez Perotti. Nicholas Pasquale Santini. Amanda Nicole Schiavo, cum laude. Devin Michael Curtis Schoonover. Robert William Chase Scroggins. Jonathan Edward Serson, cum laude. Madeline Williams Shearer, summa cum laude. Andrew Chesko. Isabella Marie Simon. Elena Marie Stanishevsky, cum laude. Joseph R. Steed. Sarah Marie Steimer. Mark R. Stevens, Jr., summa cum laude. Michael Andrews Sylvester. David Daniel Tomasi. Serena Marie Tamburino, summa cum laude. Adam Teets. Amanda Thomas. Eric Elbin Thomas. Paige K. Thomas, magna cum laude. Brandon D. Van Tine. Lydia Francis Wardy. Allison Jean Ware. Sarah Ashley Weigel. Lee Caroline Weir. Christopher Scott Winkler, cum laude. Jordan Nicole Winslow. Joshua B. Winters, summa cum laude. Stephanie Elizabeth Wollett. Eric Scott Wyant II. Megan Alexis Jacobet. John Joseph Zalek. Samuel Zapala.
As Dean of the Duquesne University School of Law, and on behalf of the law school faculty, I present to the President, Ken Gormley, these students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. President Gormley, please confer on these extraordinary students the degrees they have so richly earned.
Thank you, Dean Barton, and good morning. My name is Ken Gormley, and I have the privilege of serving as the 13th president of Duquesne University. Welcome to all of the members of the incredible Duquesne University School of Law Class of 2020 and your family and friends. It's a special honor to join you for this commencement ceremony, the 105th commencement in the history of this law school. The first was a small event in the spring of 1915 in a building in downtown Pittsburgh across from the courthouse. So even as we're separated by forces beyond our control this year, we continue that proud tradition. As many of you know, I've had the honor of serving as a member of the esteemed law school faculty for over 25 years now, seven of them as dean, before taking on my current role. I've even taught some of you in my Presidents in the Constitution course, and I can tell you I have never been more proud of the great things that this law school and Dean Barton and you amazing students have been accomplishing despite the unprecedented challenges you've faced this year. So for me, participating in this special celebration is one of the high points of my academic year. And this is the moment we've been waiting for. So graduates, I'd ask all of you to rise wherever you're watching this, in your homes or wherever you are. And families, I'd ask you to focus all of your attention on your graduate as we reach this important moment in the ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, and graduates, as president of Duquesne University of the Holy Spirit, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Directors of Duquesne University and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Juris Doctor with all of the rights, privileges, and obligations pertaining thereto. Congratulations, graduates, it's official. Today, as president of this historic institution, I want to honor your achievements and congratulate each of you attaining this singular personal and professional accomplishment. As Dean Barton and Judge Housie stated so eloquently, you have displayed remarkable resilience and determination in completing your law degrees under these unprecedented circumstances. And with your Duquesne University law degrees, you are now destined to be leaders of the bench and the bar and our democratic system of laws and justice in the years ahead. I wish more than anything, I can tell you, that your friends and family could be here today so that we could celebrate this day in person, an incredible milestone for each of you. But I want to remind you that you're still receiving two things of immense value today. The first is your official degree from Duquesne University School of Law, allowing you to serve others and make meaningful contributions for the rest of your lives. The second thing, though, is this group of lifelong friends and colleagues that you have made during your time at Duquesne. I can tell you, after a quarter century of teaching here, the friendships and relationships you have made with classmates and friends at this special law school are among the most valuable thing you will ever receive in life, a true gift. They are the key to even bigger things as you embark on your careers. And I can assure you there will be lots of exciting things ahead. As Dean Barton said, these fellow students have been there for you, and they will always be there for you. They're weathering this crisis with you right now, and you'll continue to support each other in the coming months as you work together to navigate a new normal in our nation and show others the path forward. You'll also look to these same friends and classmates in the years ahead when you achieve many new successes in the years to come, 35 years from now, you may not believe this, but I've seen it happen over and over again. You'll be there for each other when one of you is elected to the state Supreme Court or becomes the managing partner of a major law firm or becomes an esteemed judge working in the trenches of our judicial system like our speaker today, Judge Housie. There's no question these things are going to happen to you because you have the talent, drive, and leadership skills in this class that will set you apart. Speaking of Judge Housie, I should say I was fortunate to work with him when I was dean of the law school. I know personally the depth of his compassion and conviction. The same is true for the two adjunct faculty members, Judge Jeffrey Manning and Judge Thomas Hardiman, who you've honored today with the Faculty Excellence Awards. And what wonderful choices you have made in selecting them. I have seen firsthand how all three of these judges continue to embody this university's historic mission to serve God by serving students so that you students, in turn, can serve others. And that's what you're poised to do today as graduates of Duquesne University School of Law. You will go forth as they have done and serve the needs of others, always remembering the law school's motto that appears on the wall when you first walk in the building in Hanley Hall off to the left, Solus Populi Suprema Lex. The welfare of the people is the highest law. Today, you become alumni of one of the nation's finest and most rigorous institutions of legal education. Ladies and gentlemen, I know this class of graduates. They're defined by a collective sense of integrity. They have big hearts and want to add a shining luster to the legal profession, a profession that occupies a niche at the very heart of our American system of law and justice. I can personally vouch for this class of 2020, and I can't imagine a better class to represent Duquesne University and its School of Law in the professional world as leaders of the bench, the bar, and of our society for years to come. And so, on behalf of more than 8,000 current law school alumni and 95,000 alumni of Duquesne University, I wish you extraordinary success and happiness, and I salute you on this magnificent achievement as you receive your well-earned Juris Doctorate degrees and join the elite group of Duquesne Law alums who have come before you for over a century. Class of 2020, congratulations to each of you. We're enormously proud of you. God bless. And one last thing, finally, before we conclude today's commencement ceremony, I'm honored to be able to welcome a special group of esteemed individuals who wanted to share a few words with you today. These leaders of the bench and the bar and public life are towering figures. They have a wealth of experience and wisdom. They are at the very pinnacle of the legal profession and other prominent occupations. They're joining us by video because they wanted to convey their own pride and best wishes for our graduates. So, ladies and gentlemen and graduates, I'm honored to introduce an all-star lineup of luminaries to wrap up this historic virtual commencement ceremony as they pay tribute to the incredible Duquesne Law School class of 2020.
I extend my sincere congratulations to the graduating class upon having successfully completed your course of legal studies, and my best wishes as you embark upon your new career. Although you will be entering the legal profession in a particularly challenging environment, with adversity comes opportunity. I have every confidence that your Duquesne education has well equipped you to persevere and succeed. Good luck to all of you.
Hello, Duquesne University School of Law, Class of 2020. This is Travis Williams, president of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Congratulations to all of you on graduating from one of the best law schools in the United States. Yes, I may be a little biased since I graduated there in 1996. In all seriousness, you have achieved something great, something that you will be able to take with you and use for years to come, no matter where life takes you. While it did not end in the way that you probably hoped or expected, it doesn't matter. No one will remember that you didn't have a normal 3L year or that you didn't get to have a traditional graduation ceremony. They will remember, however, the fact that you persevered through a very difficult and extremely unusual time in our lives. They will remember the fact that you marched through it, completed your degree, and went into the marketplace with your head held high. And they will absolutely remember the fact that you knocked it out of the park in your first job after graduating from Duquesne University School of Law. I wish you all the best in your future careers. Let's go Dukes, and of course, let's go Bucks.
Hey, 2020 graduates. Congratulations on your graduation from the Duquesne University School of Law. We're all very happy for you and very proud of you. You've accomplished a lot to get you to this point today. You know it's a milestone in your life. There are many unsung heroes here with you, and I'm referring, of course, to your parents and your loved ones who have supported you every step of the way. You are our future. We look forward to welcoming you to the practice of law, and I implore you to leave the world a better place.
Hello, I'm Art Rooney II from the Duquesne University School of Law, class of 1982. And I want to congratulate the Duquesne University class of 2020 on your graduation. I know these are unusual times, but you have something that can never be taken away from you, and that's a degree from Duquesne University. So I hope you will use that as part of the foundation for great success in life. A lot of people that came before you used that degree to great success. And so I wish you all the best, a lot of success. And obviously with the many challenges ahead of us in this country, we're gonna need the young men and women to lead us through this as time on. So congratulations, good luck, all the best.
Hi, this is Rocky Blyer, and I want to extend my congratulations to the Duquesne Law School graduating class of 2020. You worked hard to get to where you are today. Now go out and make a difference.
Duquesne class of 2020, congratulations for a job well done. Not only have you survived law school, but you're going to survive this pandemic. Good luck in the future, and stay healthy.
Congratulations to all of you. I'm Justice Christine Donahue, Duquesne Law, 1980. You are graduating from law school at a very unusual time. You're entering into an environment that is very unusual, but I am certain that you will not only adapt, but flourish in this new world that will require smart, ethical, and compassionate lawyers like you. So celebrate your accomplishment. And again, congratulations to you and your family.
Greetings, graduates. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments at Duquesne. Best wishes on a legal career ahead. I know that you'll find much in the law to challenge you. No matter what path your career takes you, I know you'll find it enriching, and I encourage you to keep an open mind about pathways in which the law might take you. Be sure to take as much responsibility as you can. Be open to new opportunities and new challenges. You never know what'll come your way. For now, again, congratulations on the milestone you've achieved. You've done a lot of hard work. The bar exam lies ahead. More challenges will come, but you've been fortified by a great education at a great institution, and I wish you well.
Congratulations, members of the class of 2020. While your commencement exercises may be virtual, your hard work and accomplishments are very real. As you take this important step toward entering the legal profession, I salute you and all those people who inspired you to become a law school graduate. Congratulations and best wishes.
Hi, I'm Tom Klein, class of 1978, Duquesne University School of Law. wishing the very best to the class of 2020. I always say that there is no shortage of great causes and no oversupply of great lawyers. Continue in the Duquesne tradition and bring justice to all. Godspeed and good luck.
Congratulations to all of you, and congratulations to your family and the others who sacrificed so to bring you here today. You are our lawyers of the future, and there will be a future. This pandemic will pass. Unfortunately, on the other side, I will still be old, but you will all still be young. Pass the bar, gain some experience in any way you can. Justice Donahue and I will come, as is our practice, to congratulate you and swear you in as attorneys in Pennsylvania after the bar exam. In the meantime, get ready for a great life in the law. Stay safe. Make the lemons that we've been dealt into lemonade. Congratulations again.
Most sincere congratulations to the class of 2020. You're entering a new phase of your life now, a life that has many challenges. And my hope for you is that whatever you do in both your professional and personal lives, you do your best with courage, compassion, integrity, and kindness. And that you take the opportunities that come your way to make a positive difference in the lives of others. So please be well, stay in touch, and again, most sincere congratulations.
Bow your heads and ask for God's blessing now that you have graduated. When your classes are finished and your degree awarded, may you continue to seek wisdom and understanding and use what you have learned to make your community a better place for all people. When the speakers have left the stage and the dais is empty, may your voice fill the void and carry the message of God's mercy and love to all who have not yet heard it. When the fanfares have ceased and the musicians gone home, may your song ring out to rouse those whose hearts are weary and whose spirits are faint. When the applause has died down and the crowds filed out, may you acknowledge all whose support sustained you and gave you strength. When your gown is folded and the tassel has been taken from your cap, may you store up a treasure of memories from which your faith will continue to grow. When the photos have been taken and the cameras put away, may you remain standing with your face to the sun and with your arms encircling the people you love. Now that you have graduated from Duquesne University, may the Spirit who gives life bless you and accompany you wherever your journey leads you. Now that you have graduated, be blessed in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. Congratulations, Duquesne Law Class of 2020. I'm Melissa, and I'm the president of the DLAA, and let me be one of the first to welcome you into this great group of alumni. I know your journey isn't over, but remember that Duquesne has given you the tools necessary to reach your final prize. If you need anything, don't hesitate to reach out to the great group of alumni that we have.
Hey, Duquesne Law Class of 2020. This is Joe Williams. Congratulations on this significant accomplishment. I know how hard you've worked to get here. The world might seem pretty uncertain right now, but to me, that just means that more than ever, we need people who are willing to work hard to make a difference and be impactful. And I know that your class will do just that. Congratulations, and I wish you the best of luck.
Hello, class of 2020. I know this must be an exciting time for you, and I wanted to just share a message. My name is Nicola Henry Taylor, and I am a 1996 graduate of the law school, as well as the diversity director for the law school. I am so excited for you and for your accomplishments, and I want to let you know that our alumni association supports you. We want to see you succeed, and we are excited for what new challenges, as well as successes, you will be engaging in.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations on making it this far and making it through law school. As you can see, everything has been changing, and I know it's been a rough final semester for you, but congratulations on making it through again. And it's been rough for us. As you can see, I'm having to talk over my son because he's my new work partner when I'm working from home. And as you can see, it's also illegal to do that behind me. But good luck in your future endeavors, and I know you'll make it through.
My name is Gary Caruso. I'm a retired judge from Westmoreland County. I was a 1973 graduate of Duquesne University Law School. I want to congratulate the graduates of Duquesne University Law School in this year of 2020. You can be assured that your education will surely prepare you for what you are about to encounter in the real world.
Hello, Duquesne Law Class of 2020. I'm Nikki Velasaris-Lykos, Class of 2007, here to congratulate you on this wonderful accomplishment. I know when you started this journey a few years ago as One Owls, you could have never imagined you would be having a virtual graduation or that your bar exam would be postponed because of a worldwide pandemic. We are certainly living in unprecedented times, but rest assured, your fellow Duquesne Law alumni are here for you. We know that you've worked hard. We congratulate you on this milestone, and we wish you the best in the next steps of your journey.
I'd like to congratulate all of our graduates of the law school. I'm Bill Kai on behalf of the Board of Governors for the Alumni Association. Welcome.
Duquesne Law, Class of 2020, Asra Hashmi here. I hope that you are all taking some time to reflect on your immense accomplishments, completing your time as Duquesne Law students. Knowing that we will get through this together, knowing that your Duquesne Law education has prepared you for the next chapter as lawyers, and knowing that the Alumni Association cannot wait to welcome you. Congratulations.
Hi, Class of 2020, Carl Zachariah, Class of 93. This year was the most unusual year in history. I think it's gonna teach you well though, because when you get into the legal profession, you never know what to expect. You always gotta be on your toes. And I'm sure you'll do great because Duquesne did great by me, and I'm sure they did the same for you. Good luck with everything you do.
Hello, Class of 2020. My name is Maggie Lewis McHugh, and I'm a 2013 graduate. This is Mac, a future 2042 graduate. There's a lot of unknowns about what the next few months look like. But one thing is for certain, you can rest assured that with a Duquesne Law School degree, you have the tools necessary to navigate any challenges that lie ahead.
Class of 2020, congratulations on a wonderful achievement. You will be among the strongest classes to have ever graduated Duquesne Law School because of these unusual circumstances. I'm Joe Valenti, a proud graduate of the class of 2009, and I welcome you into our Alumni Association.
Congratulations to the Duquesne Law Class of 2020. I'm Judge Mike McCarthy, and I appreciate the opportunity to appear in front of you, because soon you'll be appearing in front of me. Class of 2020, 2020 strong, Join the alumni. Be part of this opportunity. Congratulations. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Greetings to the Duquesne University School of Law graduating class of 2020. Congratulations on your achievement. Now, go out and make the world a better place.
Hi, I miss you. Congratulations, you did it. The world stopped, but you kept going. Now go out there and be awesome. Bye.
Congratulations, Duquesne Law class of 2020. The grit and perseverance you've shown this semester, as well as throughout the rest of your law school career, has been amazing to watch. I can't wait to see what all of you will do in the future. Congratulations. Enjoy this day.
Congratulations, graduates. When you walked into your first class at Duquesne, excited and a little bit anxious, I bet you could barely imagine this day. For some of you, that first class was my Civ Pro class. It was also my first class at Duquesne, and I can tell you I was excited and more than a little bit anxious. Since then, I've been looking forward to this day. I knew you could do it. I know you will keep doing great things, and I am so proud of you.
Congratulations, Duquesne Law, class of 2020, on earning your Juris Doctorate degree. I know it didn't end up the way any of us had expected or hoped for, but you all were successful nonetheless, and I'm sure that you'll all go on to do great things.
Congratulations to the entire class of 2020, and a special congratulations to my appellate moot court board students. You're not only phenomenal advocates, but you're wonderful people as well, and it's been an honor working with you. We're counting on you to go out and do good and to make the world a better place. Please keep me posted on all of your accomplishments. Congratulations again, and go Dukes.
Congratulations. It's been a great privilege to have been one of your professors. If I can be of any assistance to you in preparing for the bar exam, please email or call.
Congratulations on graduating Duquesne Law. This is the end to one chapter in your life, but it's also a new beginning of your professional career. I am delighted to welcome you into the distinguished family of Duquesne alumni and the profession of lawyers. Go forth and prosper.
Congratulations on your law school graduation. I wish I was there. I want you to remember as you're studying for the bar the famous words of Steve Rogers, quote, "I can do this all day." Good luck.
Dear class of 2020, times are tough, so I had to improvise a little bit on my regalia, but I wanted to congratulate you on your graduation. You were my first class at Duquesne, and you will forever hold a special place in my heart. Congratulations, and go on to do great things.
To the Duquesne graduate class, you survived the COVID morass. No longer amateur, res ipsa loquitur. Now go out in the world and kick, well, you know.
Hello, graduates of class 2020. I am your very real Professor McPeak. And I would just like to say, on this solemnly occasion, congratulations.
Guys, can you keep it down in here? I'm trying to work. Guys.
Hey, it's Mom! Halloween!
Silly kids. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations to all of the graduates, but most especially to the LRW students from Section 61 and Section 1. I wish you all the best as you begin your legal career. Keep writing, keep reading. And may you learn something new every day.
While I am sad that I cannot deliver this message in person, I quickly remember that this is not a time for sadness, but a time of great celebration. So please, take a moment and celebrate this amazing accomplishment that you have achieved. You've accomplished great things over the past few years, and I know this is just the beginning. From my family to you and yours,
congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We're proud of you. Great job over the past 3 years, and especially the past couple months taking care of yourselves and your families. Best wishes and good luck. Wave.
Congratulations on your graduation. You've worked hard to get here, and I know good things are ahead of you. Take care, be well, and hope to see you soon.
Congratulations, everybody. You did it. I'll miss seeing all of you at the law school. I hope all of your dreams come true. The best is yet to come.
To all the 2020 Duquesne Law graduates from the Office of Admissions,
congratulations.
And good luck.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
We really enjoyed working with you over the last few years.
You're officially a Duquesne Law alum.
Good luck, you did it.
To the class of 2020, you have persevered in the most extraordinary time, and you are true Duquesne lawyers. Congratulations.
I just wanted to say congratulations to all of the graduates. We are so proud of you. We miss you. Come visit the clinic when you can. Bless you.
Congratulations. You guys are seriously amazing, and I can't wait to hear about your future and all of the wonderful things you do. Go Dukes!
Hello, this is Dr. Valerie Harper. Congratulations to all you May 2020 graduates. Much blessings on the next step in your life journey. Congratulations again. Have fun, enjoy, relax. Take care.
Hey, class of 2020, congratulations on your law school graduation. I look forward to working with you over the summer to pass the bar examination. All the best.
Hi, graduates. It's me. In all of my wild imaginings, I could never have imagined us ending up here for your graduation. You know, one of the things I really like about graduation is getting dressed up. The sun is usually shining, flowers are blooming, and we get to meet your parents, your proud, smiling, awesome parents and family members who come together to celebrate one of the biggest accomplishments of your entire lives. We're gonna miss that this year, and I'm really sorry about that. You know, one of the things I used to joke about is, you know, oh, graduation, it's not that big of a deal. The bar exam is where we really put our focus on, like, yeah, friends and family, thanks so much for coming, but you know, the biggest accomplishment is gonna be passing the bar. You know, and I think that this whole situation is proving me wrong on that point. Your graduation from law school is incredibly important. And although we are celebrating in a non-traditional way, I look forward to the time when we can get back together and engage in the pomp and circumstance that signifies all of the hard work that you've done, and we can all come together to celebrate this incredible accomplishment. Hang in there, guys. Let's continue to be flexible. Let's continue to be resilient, and let's continue to be there for one another. Take good care. Happy graduation.
Congratulations, graduating class of 2020. We're so proud of you and wish you all of the best in the future. And let me tell you this for the last time. Don't forget to check for your green screen and your confirmation email. You've done it.